I'm a second year PhD student at the Department of Urban Studies and Planning. My focus is on air pollution. Well, I did my undergrad in India. I don't think even at that point that I knew a lot of women scientists or women in STEM. And my role model was really my grandfather, who was the only other engineer that I knew.
So my name is Nusha Gailey. I am currently the president and co-founder of BioBot Analytics. So when I started engineering and architecture school, the people that I admired were women. I think one example that everyone at MIT knows is Neri Oxman. I was probably just as impressed by obviously her work, but I could also see something relatable when I looked at her was, she's a woman, she's like me, and maybe one day I can be like that.
So my name is Jessica Snyder, and I work at NASA Ames Research Center, and I'm a STEM scientist. So I think a part of who I am is I'm my mother's daughter, and she introduced me to people like Jane Goodall as a role model, you know, Sylvia Earle, who explores the oceans, and Sally Ride, astronauts like that, hugely technically competent, inspirational in what they've done.
My name is Francesca Dominici. I am a professor of biostatistics, data science, and population health at the Harvard THN School of Public Health and a co-director of the Harvard Data Science Initiative. I have a lot of fantastic colleagues that are female. They are now my peer. And of course, I am absolutely passionate about making sure that the junior have role models. But no, I never had the role model.
I think it's important to have female role models. I think also extremely important is to have peers, like other women and men that you respect, that you enjoy talking to. There's people here at Ames that talk about decades ago when they'd be the only woman in a meeting, and now it's almost 50-50. And so being able to have that conversation and sort of celebrate how things have shifted gives me an appreciation of the history. I think it's really important to extend mentorship to other women. And so I volunteered with the Science Club for Girls. And that's a group that works with roughly third grade age girls to about eighth grade. And every week you go and you do some science clubs.
When, as a female in STEM, when you're young and we are trying to find your career path, I think there are a lot of support from, of course, female, but also male in advancing your career. I think when it's becoming a real problem is when you're becoming in a leadership position as well. And I think that's where you get the glass ceiling. As you're raising and you're trying to, you know, either at the same level or at the higher level, then I think there is a pushback. I think it's still very present since then.
Within the education system, we see a lot more parity than you do in industry. And so when you're in a STEM-related field in industry, that gender discrepancy is amplified a lot more than academia. And part of it is probably a lack of role models. I started admiring people like Sheryl Sandberg, but she was like one of three people that I could really identify and say, she's amazing, and one day I want to be like her. That probably contributes a lot to why women don't start companies within the STEM field. My co-founder and I are both women. We are getting inundated with applications from phenomenal women.
I see in a certain way that we are stuck. To me, there are two concrete steps. One is to equip the young girl to have more confidence in themselves. But at the same time, I also think we need to hold leadership in the labs and the university accountable and recognize their effort about increasing diversity in their lab, which is not only gender diversity, by the way, it's a diversity across all spectrum. I think we are still only looking at one metric, which is impact factor of research publication, and that is one dimensional lens. And I think as long as we keep the one dimensional lens and we don't reward the leadership that make that a real issue, I think we will continue to be stuck.
Now that I'm teaching this semester, I want to be cognizant of the gender gaps, of the racial biases, etc., on this campus, and try to make sure that I create an environment that is welcoming to everybody.